Okay, friends, let's take a step back and talk about measures of center in a data set. Now, what center really means is what is typical with respect to a set of data. For example, some of you may have heard the word average before, and I found this fun article. This is what the average American looks like in 2018. Well, according to the US Census Bureau, the average American is a woman. Why? Because 50.8% of Americans are women. And this is one of the ways you can measure typical. If something is in the majority, that is greater than 50%, they must be the most typical. Or, in this case, they've even used the word average. But creating a percentage like that is just one way to talk about the prevalence of data. Here are some other averages. This is February, March, April, and May's average high and low temperatures for our neighborhood in Bend. Now, these are not percentages, these are degrees. 46 average high temperature in February, 25 average low temperature. That average is gotten differently than the averages that we just looked at that are percentages. So are the rain days. But there are even others besides averages and percentages. For example, median prices jump again in Central Oregon. Median, that is yet another measure of what is called center or typicality. Why do they use medians to measure house prices? Heck, what is a median versus an average versus a percentage? Don't worry, we'll get to all that. Let's back up and go to percentages first.